Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Nurdayana binti Muhammad Fazulin. So now I will introduce about the background of Alisan. Alisan Sports Sdn Bhd is the Malaysia's largest sport retailer focusing on the sale of athletic footwear, clothes and equipment. Tuan Haji Hassan Ali and Puan Malina binti Abu Bakar, a husband and wife duo, founded Alisan Sports in 1993 with a single store, 150 square foot store at Holiday Plaza, Johor Bahru. The company has grown from a sole proprietorship to a private limited company known as Alisan Sports Sdn Bhd. The company has expanded dramatically and they are now on over 135 locations in Peninsula Malaysia. Since its founding, the firm has evolved from single sport convenience concept to a multi-category, multi-concept sporting goods behemoth with a clearly segmented strategy to appeal to consumers and sports fans of all income level by providing global brand at a reasonable price. The Asian Retail and Franchise Federation presented the company with the Asian Business Outstanding Award 2011, Industry Class Sector Sports Retail in 2011, when the government linked PE fund Equinas Equity National Berhad decided to buy a 35% stake of Alisan Sports in 2016. It marked a significant turning point in the company's history. The board of directors then opted to hire a worldwide sports and lifestyle retail veteran as CEO, as well as a new management team. Since then, the company has had double-digit sales growth and extraordinarily high profitable. In 2018, the Sporting Goods Intelligence Report classified Alisan as the Galaxy's 63rd largest sporting goods retailer. Alisan Sports has also received the Brand of the Year Award of for Malaysia from World Branding Council UK at the Glittering Ceremony. The core purpose of Alisan Sports is to keep Malaysia fit and active by making sports affordable for all. Their mission is to dominate the sporting goods landscape by engaging the deeper and creating strong ties with over 20 million sports lovers of Malaysia.
Assalamualaikum. I would like to discuss about the implementation of knowledge management tools by Alisan Company. The first implementation is in terms of customer relationship system. Alisan expand its operation through e-commerce called alisan.com. The website designed to help customers learn more about the products available at Alisan. The website provides product categories such as men, women, kids and also sports. These features help buyers to quickly find their desired products. Aside from that, website also provides customer support services by allowing customer to communicate with staff who can assist them to resolve any issues, such as how to make online purchases and to obtain the customer order information. The next implementation is in terms of automation system. Alisan has developed ClickView software system. This system working directly with our system, and the ClickView created dashboards and data analytics templates for Alisan company. This to enable them to monitor and measure data on a daily basis. Last but not least, content and document management system. DMS and CMS are essential for the organization to use. This is because they help with document management. Alisan store and distribute information to internal and also external users via social media, which is Facebook and also Instagram, namely Alisan Sports. It helps users in gathering information such as the most recent times, customer satisfaction and also the demand.
Now I will explain about the evolution of implementation. Alisan appears to have used knowledge acquisition where they seek knowledge from outside sources such as customers by implementing customer relationship management, which allows Alisan to interact better with the customers, especially when they have expected and nearly accurate data about them. This helps businesses to get to know their consumers better and more thoroughly, making it simpler for them to provide what they want. Alisan offers customer service via its official website and social media, allowing customers to contact the firms at any time and express their thoughts on their Alisan purchasing experience. Customer feedback and reviews, in fact, will be used to help businesses gain a better understanding of their customers and enhance their service. As a result, demand for Alisan products is likely to increase. Next, the automation system that used by Alisan may make daily monitoring and measurement of essential parameters more easier. The ClickView system, for example, is integrated with the existing enterprise resource planning ERP system by Alisan to extract historical data from its database, which can describe the time it takes for an item to be sold based on current inventory on hand. Thus, companies have been able to learn the sorts of items they sell and apply this knowledge on future orders, thanks to the capacity to extract information from previous trends. At the same time, it can also contribute to the benefits of a good inventory management system, as well as improve product information management to support its rapidly expanding e-commerce operation. Third, content and document management system. LSM may easily share their information and knowledge with their customer using social media platforms such as Facebook, Instagram, and LSM owned websites. Customers will be able to make the best selection or choice when buying sporting items from LSM as a result of this information and knowledge. In fact, the LSM website is user-friendly, making it simple for all parties to use. The protection of customer data and documents is immensely valuable and paramount at LSM. Customers' personal information will be safely and privately maintained by them. As a result, customers do not need to be worried and may use LSM service with a complete trust.
Next, I would like to present about the challenge faced by LSM. The first challenge is poor customer engagement. According to Haryana 2016, customer engagement is referred to emotional attachment that a customer experiences during the repeated and ongoing interactions. Although LSM is a big company, they still have a problem in managing their customer engagement. People know that LSM offers delivery service to customer. However, customer was not satisfied with their service. By referring to the media social of LSM, for example Facebook, there are a lot of customer comments about the bad service. For instance, LSM always send the wrong item to the customer. Not only that, LSM customer service also always engage. The numbers given seems like not available at many times. Therefore, it causes a problem for customers to ask questions about the problem or getting refund. As a big company that using social computing tools, they are supposed to create a good relationship with the customer in order to maximize its sales from existing or new customer and to increase the customer satisfaction towards company. The second challenge is competitors, which is one of a common challenge that faced by all business or company. For information, Vaj Pillai Lau was appointed as Chief Executive Officer in January 2017. According to him, LSM faced a large number of competitors. There are other companies in the same industry which offers a similar product and services and also put the target of same audience of customers. This gives effect on the gross margin and as a consequence, the overall profitability. However, the CEO of LSM has come up with a clear positioning strategy to cope with the problem. The third challenge faced by LSM is change in demand. To compare with other business, LSM deals with a lot of many things as the company sells the sportswear and equipment from the various global brands. For example, they need to deal with the type, color, and size of every sportswear and equipment. This has added another degree of complexity to the management of stock keeping units, SKU. Day by day, the product selection change following the trend. Therefore, it is quite challenge for LSM to fulfill the demand.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Zulaikha Bachrodin. So I would like to continue for the next part, which is suggestion for the challenges in the implementation. So the first suggestion is make your brand relatable and meaningful. Making the user experience seamless and efficient is only one aspect of successful customer engagement. It's also about developing a brand personality that customers will like learning about and want to interact with. This is where brand recognition comes into play. Before connecting with a brand, the client must be aware of its existence and that it offers something unique, relevant or beneficial. To draw customers' attention and provide possibilities for involvement, LSM, a sports shop, must try to develop a feeling of purpose and connection with them. Part of it will come from the sense of authenticity that can instill in your brand, which is critical for today's brand-weary and socially concerned customers. Others may be inspired by the personal narrative of how the brand was founded and the passion that inspired it. Look for the methods to allow your company's real character to show so that customers may become aware of it, relate to it, and engage with it. The second suggestion is competitive audits. Pulling a listing online is convenient, but it misses a valuable resource that sales managers may tap into. The team of sales professionals that visit the shop and interact with rivals on a regular basis.
It's one thing for your representative to see a rival on the shelf every time they go shopping, but it's another to acquire that observation from them and analyze it meaningfully. Furthermore, very few sales staff want to spend their days doing anything other than selling. So the key to a successful competitive audit is organization. Otherwise, it will be difficult work for both the shop representative and you to capture. The third suggestion is improve your business processes. A process review and improvement exercise can identify inefficiencies, conflict or gaps, while also finding ways to fix those issues by streamlining operation. Map out your current processes and analyze them to identify shortcomings. Al-Ihsan can apply the information to redesign how their business operates through researching their target markets, which is estimating demand. Al-Ihsan must anticipate that the majority of sales will be conducted online or through mail order. They need to know whether the local demand for the Al-Ihsan sports shop will be sufficient. Al-Ihsan must recognize that the industry is competitive and the number of independent sports stores has been dropping over time. If that's the case, keep in mind that while demand for trendy sportwear is more or less stable, individuals tend to move to cheaper things when the economy is fading. So that's all from me. Thank you.
In conclusion, Al-Ihsan places great emphasis on knowledge management. They take full advantage of the use of knowledge management tools to get a positive impact. Among the effect we can see, they are able to enhance customer experience. Other than that, employees get their productivity increased. Al-Ihsan also encourage collaboration by becoming an authorized seller, reseller of other brands such as Canterbury, Nike, Asics and so on. They also can be seen to improve governance and compliance as time goes by. They also get feedback from their loyal customer about their onboard staff and customers fast. Last but not least, they manage to minimize error in their system and manage risk to almost zero risk. To assist its fast growing e-commerce company, Al-Ihsan is currently pioneering product information management and customer relationship management project. They are working to upgrade time by time to keep their business growing along with the trending fashion and technology. That's all from us. Thank you very much.